Hi everyone and welcome to Adobe Live.
Hi Dan.
Hey.
Hey, good to see you.
Good to be here.
So we will be together for 3 days, starting with Dan Mumford, and then we will have Mara Grunlund, we will have James Curran making animated GIFs, we will have also Maite Franke making illustrations. So this is a stream for you, 3 days of creativity with the artist, and they will just create live in front of you, and you can ask them questions using the chat. So make sure to have the full experience on adobelive.com. Also, people on YouTube, you can join us on adobelive.com because we have special things for you during 3 days. First, we'll give away signed prints from these artists.
It's true.
It's true. And one per hour. Okay, so stay with us because in 1 hour we'll give away one Dan's print. Actually, an illustration he will create over these 3 days. So you will explain what this is. So every hour we give away something. And also we are running a contest. So if you are on adobelive.com, you can check the contest tab on the right. It will explain the rules, but basically we invite you to create an illustration or an animation based on the theme, which is Max. Okay, so why Max? Because within 2 weeks with Dan, we will be at Adobe Max in San Diego. It's the creativity conference with, more than 9,000 designers attending. I mean, it will be huge. So just take the three letters, okay, this word, Max, create something, share it on Twitter using the Adobe Live hashtag, and the top 10 entries will get Creative Cloud subscriptions, okay? So just be creative. So who do we have in the chats? We have people from Brazil, from Wisconsin, very precise.
Yeah.
Precise. Tel Aviv, Israel. Hi, good to see you. Hamburg, Germany. That's great. Dan, where are you from?
London.
London. Okay. So you took the train this morning?
Yeah, took the train this morning. Took a few hours. Very easy. Lovely to be in Europe.
Okay.
I hope we stay in Europe.
Yeah, because by the way, we are live streaming from Paris. Which is a first, because usually we stream from San Francisco, but this time it's live from Paris. So great. So maybe we should show what's happening on your screen, yeah. And you can describe what you want to create over 2 days. So let me switch your screen. Here we go.
Okay. So essentially what we're going to do over the next 3 days is create a landscape piece that is just sort of quite a fun sort of thing that I wanted to do. It's got a nicely sort of skewed composition to it, and while doing that I'll be sort of going through some different techniques from coloring and composition to layering and things like that. I'm going to be doing it all on the iPad Pro in Adobe Draw.
Okay, so Adobe Illustrator Draw, maybe we can explain the free application.
Uh-huh, yep.
It's available on iOS and also on Android. Okay. Actually, I think I have super cool stuff that I can. Let me find it. Direction? Or maybe not. Maybe it's not here. I had some images, you know, to show and say, "Hey."
You can't tease everyone like that.
Yeah, but you will see. So if you're on adobelive.com, you will see some interactive stuff. So maybe I can show them. So for the people on adobelive.com, I will display something for you. Just asking you if you're a member of the Creative Cloud. So these are a new interactive widgets. It's just to know more about you. Feel free to answer and directly engage with us. Okay, Mr. Martian, make sure to refresh the page because this is working on my side. And we have people from Algeria, Colombia, Vietnam, Brazil, Bahrain. I mean, wow. It's a worldwide stream.
All over the place.
All over the place.
It's great.
So you, how will you achieve this, like step by step?
Okay, so this is essentially what we're looking at right here is my sketch that I worked up. So this is all very, very loose and very sketchy.
Okay, so for you, this is a sketch.
This is my sketch. Yeah, yeah. This is sort of like a 30-minute.
I was thinking this was a final illustration.
No.
Oh, okay.
Sorry. No. We're gonna get a lot more detail.
This is
this.
A sketch.
So normally I would spend maybe, I don't know, minimum of 12 hours working up a piece of artwork.
Uh-huh.
So we've got 6 hours. So we can do that though. It'll be fine.
Yeah.
But yeah, this is how I always start my work, with a fairly finished composition where all the colours are in place. And actually, there's actually a few things we're going to do afterwards that will go beyond this, what it looks like here. But we'll get to that on day three. So a little teaser to make sure people tune back in for the third day. But yeah, this is, so basically I do this so that I've got a basis to work from. And it's easier to make changes at the sketch stage than it is, you know, later on.
Yeah, sure.
When you've spent ages working on something.
So do you have a name for this illustration? Or?
I don't yet, no. Maybe
then
chat,
we can ask them.
Yeah, maybe the chat can help us with that. Okay. Yeah, so...
So people in the chat, find a...
Get thinking.
Yeah, get thinking and find a title. I will try to pick the best title in... You will be the final judge, okay?
Okay.
You will decide. Right.
You,
okay.
You get the top three.
Yeah, top three.
Okay, so I guess we should probably start drawing, yeah?
Yeah, so you're using Illustrator Draw.
Yep, with the... I've got the pencil.
And
the first thing...
Rufus, maybe you can put the link in the chat to Illustrator Draw,
yes.
People. And you're using, yeah, the Apple Pencil.
So the way I've got things set up here, I have the sketch that I've done on two layers and in between a draw layer. And what that means is that I can essentially have a very transparent version of the sketch to sort of use to trace the shape of what I want from my sketch. But it also means I can see what I'm hoping the final thing looks like. So in this situation, what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick my color. I'm going to start with this purple foreground element. And then essentially what I'm going to do is just start drawing in some shapes, I think. Because in a situation like this, where there's quite a big bit of block colour, it's good to get the shape in there, and then you can sort of carve in the details afterwards, I find. So, as an example, what I might do is just get this shape in here, and then you can fill it in like that, which is quite cool. So... just going to sort of start to build it up like
so
this.
So we have some titles already, such as...
Already?
Girls Walks Alone in a Purple City at Night. And it's very, very precise.
Very nice, very nice.
Another one which is post-apocalyptic.
I mean, it is. It certainly
it
is, yeah.
It is, okay.
Yeah, you'll see that in a lot of my work.
Yeah.
Post-apocalyptic. I just like things that are falling apart, you know?
So how many times did you experience the apocalypse already in your
life?
Every week?
Up to this point, yeah, every week. Something goes wrong every week, yeah. You know what? I often think it might be quite fun to experience the apocalypse. I don't know. Maybe that's just me. I'm sure that's just me.
And we have Kiss Kyle asking what pen you're using. So maybe it's someone who's asking, like, what is this weird green...
Oh!
Elements.
It's so that I don't lose the top.
Ah, you don't lose the top. So this is the Apple Pencil. So just for the iPad Pro. But you can use... you can use Illustrator Draw on any kind of iPad with any kind of pencil, including the one by adding it, including your finger. Yeah.
Yeah,
can
yeah.
Work too. It's just that here you can play with the pressure, I guess.
And yeah.
It's more precise than the finger.
Yeah, it's really good. It's... The pencil is very, very precise, and the settings in... In fact, I'll just show that quickly what I've got. So the settings I've got for my pen here is so that it's got a real nice taper to it, which means that, you know, the harder I push down, the thicker the line's going to get. What I'm doing right now is not really going to have much detail in it. We're just laying down those really basic blocks of colour so that then we can... zoom in a little bit and get a bit more detailed with it.
Okay. So just big shapes and
just big shapes to start, yeah.
Okay.
Makes sense. It's sort of just making it look right from a very, very basic point of view at this point.
Yeah, we have someone in the chat who says that they have fat fingers. So that's why
they do. I thought you meant I do. Whew. Because you can get
how dare you?
You get out of the chat if you're saying that about my fingers.
I love this British expression. How dare you?
How dare they? Do you want me to be very, very typically British?
Be typically British, and I would be typically French.
Right? Okay, that would work. Good.
Let's do that for 2 minutes only.
Okay, go on then.
Oh, merde.
You can't speak in French though, because I don't know what you're saying.
So, what is happening in the chat right now? I am with my friend Dan, who is coming from Great Britain. Beautiful country. It's on the other side of the sea, called La Manche.
I can't do this because I'll just be accidentally racist. So I can't do it. I can't do it. I'm just going to be quiet now.
Just a quiet then.
Yeah, I'm just going to be quiet. I'm just going to stay here. Okay. So, oops. So, we've got...
Yes, Darren, so he's using Adobe on the tablet. Will this stream be available to watch letters? Yes. Actually, this stream will be available on Adobe Live in the replay section that I will activate tomorrow. But also, if you go on the Creative Cloud YouTube channel, you will find the live streams as replay, like as classic video on demand right after the stream. So to make sure to receive a notification when the streams are live and when the replays are ready, make sure to subscribe to the Adobe Creative Cloud YouTube channel. If you're on YouTube, click on the subscribe button. If you're on adobelive.com, there is a subscribe button at the bottom of the player, just below the player. Oh, we have a name here.
Oh,
Purple,
yeah.
Purple, but I won't be able to pronounce it, so I have to show it here.
Purple Rain. That's good. Very good.
Purple Rain. Two times. Purple Dream. By Matt.
Let's move away from the purple guys. Let's get some, let's get
another
some...
Another purple guy.
Let's get some other things going in there, like, what does it make you feel?
Emotion.
Yeah, what emotions?
Okay. So, Mohabed is asking you, Dan, where did you get the idea for this illustration? Do you know, source of inspiration for this one? Is it just traveling to Paris?
Do you know what? I think I kind of wanted to do something that looked like I think it was after seeing the new trailer for the film Doctor Strange that's coming out, because in that it's got these cities that are sort of collapsing in on themselves.
Yeah, emerging.
So I kind of wanted to do a landscape that looked like it was kind of just slightly askew, and just want to do something that just wasn't quite right, but at the same time was recognizable as a cityscape, essentially.
Nice. So we have a good question by Sarah.
Yeah.
Is that a ruler tool in the app, or is it a ruler on top of the iPad?
It's in the app. So if we go up to the to the top, we have these shapes.
And that's great, actually. I mean, to draw perfect lines, perfect circles.
Yeah. Yeah. No, it's really good. It's really useful. What you can do is you can turn with your two fingers. If I go back to it now, you can turn it to certain degrees, and it snaps automatically at 90 degrees, which is really good.
Oh yeah, nice.
And also, if you sort of hover, so I'm going for 20 degrees because that's the angle I want, and then you can just slide it around and it sticks to that.
Nice.
So if I zoom out, I've just got rid of that. Whoops. What we've got here is that it's sort of like it's a perfect rectangle, but slightly 20 degrees. So all of these lines going down here are 70 degrees on the ruler, and then going across are 20 degrees. So I've sort of done a little bit of preparation there so that I can maintain a sort of nice grid while I'm working.
Hmm. Interesting. So you have more suggestions. Yellow Fear.
Interesting.
Another one, Lost Future.
Ooh, I like that one. Yeah, that's nice.
Okay, keep the ideas coming.
Yeah, keep them coming.
So remember that, stay with us, because anytime we will give away a signed print of this illustration, signed by Dan, otherwise doesn't make any sense.
No.
I can sign it.
You can sign it, yeah.
It would not be the same value.
It would not be worth more.
Oh, yeah. Way more.
Both signatures.
Yeah. Too much expensive.
Yeah, that's true, actually.
So, okay. So, Yeah, stay with us. It will be very simple. You just have to stay with us. And at some point, we will give away a signed print to one of you in the chat. Also, you can participate in the online contest. So on adobelive.com, just check on the right. There is a contest tab with the rules. And it explains how to participate. So basically, you create an illustration or an animation based on the theme Max. And then you can publish it on social, like on Twitter, Instagram, just add the Adobe Live hashtag.
So here's a good example of me doing that stuff with the ruler. So now I've locked it into that angle. I can move it around as much as I want, and it's sticking at that 70 degrees angle, which is really good when I want all of these lines to be going in the same way. Because, you know, sometimes when you're doing stuff with your fingers, it can be a bit fiddly, but...
And they are very creative with the titles.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I probably got now.
Existential collapse.
Oh, man.
Diving into the unknown.
These are good.
Yeah, they're good.
We've got a lot to choose from here.
Yeah.
Just keep coming. We'll get one eventually, and I'm...
And
you know.
Tristar is suggesting city roots. Something very, maybe like the roots of the tree.
Yeah. Well, there is sort of a sort of nature taking over industrial stuff here. So it's, there's definitely a bit of that in here.
So Mohammed is asking, okay, in your workflow, will you use another Creative Cloud app at the end? So this will be on day three, right?
Yeah. So I think what we're going to do right at the end is go to Photoshop.
Okay, because it's true that from Illustrator Draw, at any point you can maybe you can show the menu, but at any point you can say send to Illustrator, and then you keep all the vectors, so you can change the colors and everything.
Yeah.
But you can also say send to Photoshop, and it will send a high resolution version of your artwork, and then you will. So what do you do in Photoshop? You play with the lights, or?
Well, the thing is, normally I do my work in Photoshop.
Yeah.
So actually, working with vectors is not what I normally do.
Yeah.
But draw, as far as drawing on the iPad goes for me, is the closest to how I draw. Because I just make very clean lines within Photoshop. So what I normally do if I'm working on the iPad is I'll finish something in draw, send it to Illustrator, and then export it from there, probably at a really high resolution.
Okay.
And then within Photoshop, I'll change colors and just tweak anything that I sort of forgot to do, essentially. So it's a nice sort of workflow. And it works pretty seamlessly, to be honest with you. So starting to build up this. And it's going to look quite messy at this stage, but the thing is, eventually all this will get it'll get cropped down. So at this stage, it's sort of, you know, I've got all these extra bits on the edges and stuff, but we're not going to worry too much about that.
So they want to know more about you, like besides illustration, are there other design fields you're interested in, or maybe you can talk about a little bit about your background.
Yeah,
I know your background because I attended OFF, and
we did that.
We
together,
were on stage
that, yeah.
together for OFF. Some people,
quite a few people. Yeah, that was
people.
A little bit. That was quite daunting.
It was about your journey as a designer.
My saga.
Saga.
yeah. So basically, what do you want right from the start? Where do you want to start?
Yeah, from the start. A to Z.
I was going to give away my birthday then, but I'll leave that now. So I did illustration at Brighton University, and after I graduated from there, I worked within the alternative music industry. So I mainly did like
Katy Perry.
I mainly did Katy Perry. You know, Madonna, that sort of thing.
Yeah,
no,
yeah.
I did a lot of punk band work because that's the sort of background I grew up from. And lots of kind of gory artwork, you know, horror stuff, monsters, these sort of things. Because that's what I really enjoyed as a kid. And so I sort of brought that across into this music that I enjoyed and grew up with. And it meant that I could sort of merge these loves of mine and create artwork as well. And from that, I sort of slowly over... Well, I mean, I've been freelance for about 9 years now. And I think I sort of slowly moved from working in music to doing a lot of film work. A lot of film posters, alternative film posters, branding, packaging, that sort of thing. And that's where I'm at mainly now, along with doing gallery shows and things like that. And as far as influences for all that stuff go, it's really lots of, you know, it's some quite cliched stuff, but it's a lot of movies. I really love comic books, video games, movies, lots of anything to do with escapism.
Maybe I can show some of your work for our friends.
Yeah,
This is Dan's website. By the way, at belike.com, there is a speakers tab, and there is a link to his portfolio. Where should I start? Which one?
I don't know. Let's think. If we go... I know, go down a little bit. I think the... Here you go. Let's start with Star Wars. I think that is probably the four pieces I did for Episode 7 last year. They were given away at IMAX cinemas in America and the UK. And, you know, that was probably the sort of... the best way of combining things I love with doing artwork, you know? Because it's Star Wars, who doesn't, you know? That's the epitome of sort of nerd love, you know? And I love it. So being able to work on something like that was perfect. Things like Ghostbusters. You know, all of these things, the things that I grew up with and things that had an impact on me as a kid, so they're kind of, you know, they're ingrained in my memories, and they influence the way I work a lot.
This one we did it with the iPad, right?
Yes, yeah. There's a tutorial for that up now.
On the Create magazine.
Yes, yeah.
There is the link here if you want to.
Yeah,
check.
And that was I'd say that's like a 10-hour piece.
10-hour.
All done on the iPad.
Nice.
And there's a process video as well of the whole thing. So go watch that. It reduces 10 hours down to about 5 minutes, I think. So that's kind of crazy. Okay.
Okay, let's go back to your iPad.
Yeah.
What's going on?
Well, we're starting to build up a little bit of a layout here.
You have fans in the chat. Thanks for giving some love to Dan. Also, it's really the moment for you to ask questions. This is why we bring these live streams. It's an opportunity to connect with all these great artists. So, Dan, there was a good question about color by Johan Frank, who's asking, color is an essential element in your composition. How do you choose your colors? Is it from real photo, like real pictures?
No, it's not actually. It's generally just colors I like. Mm-hmm. So the interesting thing with me and color is that I used to work only in black and white.
I remember this.
Yeah, I didn't like color at all. So I started doing screen printing because I needed to challenge myself to do something with color. And by doing screen printing, it meant that I would bring in like one or two colors into my artwork. So essentially my work would be black and white with these sort of bright, vivid, like maybe a pink or a red. And so I have these sort of, I slowly went from black and white to kind of crazy colors. And now everything I do seems to mainly have really bright colors. There's certainly a color palette that works well for me. And I'll always play around with that a lot at the sketch stage. So the one we're working on now, you know, I think it started out green, to be honest with you, like mainly green. And I just kind of kept playing with it, you know. I'll get the composition to the point I want it to be, and then I'll use hue and saturation and replace color to sort of just play around with a few different color comps and just sort of wait until I've got something that works nicely.
We have a screen printer in the chat.
Oh, okay. Hello.
Anne Cooper. Hi, Anne.
You do a fine job. I can't do it. I used to do my own screen printing, and the patience you need to have for it is, I didn't have it. It's really hard. I couldn't do it. I got fed up. I think I used to print everything myself, and then I did a screen print for a band for a gig, and it had to be done for that night. I'd done like 100 prints. I got 4 colors down, came to do the final layer of black, and it didn't fit. It looked terrible. I had to throw it all away and give up, and I never printed again. It went horribly wrong. So now I get other people who are much better to do it.
Such as Anne in the chat.
Exactly.
So we have some people joining asking, okay, what's this? What are you doing? So Dan is working on illustration on an iPad Pro.
Yep.
Yeah. So you can see the sketch. It's like a CT right after the apocalypse. I mean,
that's what we're doing.
Yeah. And he's using Illustrator Draw, which is a free app on iOS and Android. So yeah, using vectors, yes, and vector is the key.
Yeah, this is Draw's vector-based.
So there are some questions about your workflow. So when you work in Photoshop, do you use a Wacom tablet? Or?
Yeah, I work in Photoshop with a Cintiq mainly.
Okay.
Which is
beautiful device.
Yeah, it's great. I love working with the Cintiq. It's I used to work on a small Wacom
Intuos Pro.
Yeah. But after switching to the Cintiq, it's very hard to go back. It's a very, very nice device.
I had the same experience.
Yeah.
Like we have one in San Francisco, and it's hard to get back to bamboo after Cintiq.
It's why working on the iPad's very, it works nicely as a sort of a mobile alternative. Mm. Sort of my workflow doesn't necessarily change that much, and it means I can create stuff. You know, your hand gets used to so if I'm working while looking at something, my hand, obviously, sort of, you have that natural flow that everything fits. And working on a Intuos or bamboo and looking at the screen now, it doesn't work as well. Like the connections between your hand and brain, it doesn't really work anymore for me. So it's either the iPad or the Cintiq. That's my general workflow. Nothing fancy, just an iMac. Works nicely.
So we have a Keskal asking, like, do you find the Cintiq reliable? Yeah, I think it's you can trust the Cintiq, right?
Oh, yeah. I think, you know, I found a lot of people I've spoken with who have tried a Cintiq and then not carried on using it.
Mm.
They've had issues with where the line's not, like, flowing with the hand properly.
Oh.
And nearly always it's just a driver problem. You just need to load something on or delete something.
Oh, okay.
And I've had this same problem where, like, you know, I'll show you now, like, instead of a line like that, I'll get a line that's like all wiggly like that.
Okay.
And it's just simply a case of you need to reload or delete
data something. Driver.
Yeah. And then it's perfect. It's a weird glitch, and it's one of those things where I don't know. Something's updated, something hasn't updated, or whatever. But if you get it working perfectly, it's fun.
Because we have Shiva masking, like, do you manage to get smooth lines? I mean, as smooth as this one using a Wacom also, like the Cintiq, or?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, do you know what? I had this conversation with a group of people at a workshop the other day, and they were using the same tools as me.
Okay.
And they were having the problem of being able to do smooth lines. And the thing is, it's practice, really. Mm. Like, you need to sort of train yourself to go with the flow and know how the tool of Photoshop works with your, you know, your hand and how you're drawing stuff. And that's it, really. It's as smooth as you want it to be. It just depends on how you draw or how you use it, I suppose. But yeah.
And JC is asking, did you try the Surface Book, which is the new tablet? So, you know, there is the Microsoft Surface Pro.
Oh, right.
They just released the Surface Book, which is like the upgraded version. Like,
do you know, I've not tried them, actually. I've played, I think, whatever the one before that was. I tried that.
Yeah. Surface Pro, or I guess.
Yeah. And that was okay.
Yeah. Yeah, the book is really like boosted.
Yeah.
Really fast.
Honestly, I'm not a real big fan of Windows.
Yeah, you're not a Windows guy.
I can't use it anymore. I think, you know, for a lot of people, I guess you go to Mac and it's hard to go back to Windows afterwards. I've certainly found that. I've tried a few times to use Windows and using the Surface and stuff, but it just didn't really work for me.
Okay, so Jimmy is asking, how long did it take you to get used to the pen pressure? You were talking about practicing, you know, the line and master.
Let's think. I think every time I've moved to a new piece of hardware, a couple of weeks. Yeah, so I remember when I moved to the...
Also, you spend hours on illustration.
So when you say
a couple of weeks, it's like some hours.
It's a long time, yeah.
Because you really try to achieve your illustrations, you know, until the end. You just...
Yes.
When you practice, I guess you don't do like curly shapes, you know?
No, not really.
You just draw.
Yeah, that's the thing. I think that does have a big impact, actually. Like, it really just comes down to practice a lot of the time, you know. And getting to know your tools and the way that they flow with how you want to work, you know. I mean, there's so many different things as well you could do with a tablet and Photoshop or Illustrator and everything. As I'm sure you'll see later on today. See loads of different techniques, you know.
So we have also, who is that? I think it was Mohammed asking, Dan, can you give us 3 tips to improve our drawing skills?
Okay.
Practice?
3 tips. I mean, genuinely, practice has to be one of those tips, okay? like, you know, that is it. I would say if you want to try and draw in a certain style, then, you know, definitely look at other people's work and try and... The thing is, it's a tough one because I don't want to say try and emulate what they're doing, because I don't think you should try and... You should try and be your own person. But you can definitely try and, like, work out how someone might have made their work. I find a lot of... it's not pleasure. What do I do? What is it? It's I enjoy looking at someone's work and trying to work out how they did it.
Yeah.
So I'm always fascinated by artwork where I don't know how they did it. To me, that's good artwork because they, you know, it's magical.
It's a challenge. Okay.
Exactly. Yeah. I think my artwork's probably quite easy to break down because I do it in these very sort of flat block colors. And it's nearly always for screen print as well, so it's there's perhaps not that much mystery behind it. But that's something I really enjoy, not knowing how someone did something. So I think that's a good way to learn as well, by trying to work out perhaps how someone's made their artwork, and then then maybe applying those techniques to your own work, or at least the mythology and the way of thinking about work. I think that's a good thing to do. Also, just look at lots of artwork. Go to galleries. Go to anything you can. You know, we're at this time when it's so easy to go and see a a small gallery show of modern artwork, you know, contemporary artwork, mm-hmm. That is, you know, it's going to be your peers, the people that are your sort of age doing the same sort of stuff as you. And that's always super inspiring to see. So definitely check out as much artwork as you can and get out there. That's what I'd say.
So now they are talking about any tips to create color palettes, and they start talking about Adobe Capture in the chat. So
Adobe Capture is really good for that.
And try to show them how it works.
Yeah. I think I've used that a few times, definitely, to find a few nice color palettes. So yeah, this is getting quite nice now. So I think what we're going to do is work on like the foreground today, mm-hmm. and then hopefully by the last day we're going to have a full-on illustration. Are you getting up a video of it?
Yeah, I'm trying to just share my iPhone screen. Okay, doesn't want to today. Maybe tomorrow. We'll see. So, is the Apple Pencil compatible with iPad 2? I don't think so. I think it requires at least this new generation of iPad Pro. The iPad Pro.
Because it's using. Does it have to be Pro?
No, there is a new generation of iPad.
Yeah.
So they use the same screen technology, but before the iPad Pro, I mean, when they released the iPad Pro, the Apple Pencil could only work with the iPad Pro, that's for sure. Because it changed the technology of the screen.
Yeah. Yeah, the iPad Pro screen is kind of crazy detailed. Like draw works really nice on the iPad Pro because it's vector based. You can zoom and zoom and zoom, and it blows my mind every time. So I could I could get super detailed in this if we wanted.
So this app is vector based, and someone is asking about the layers. So yeah, you can separate the layers and. Mm-hmm. Up to 20 layers, I think.
Yeah. I think maybe more.
Maybe more now?
Maybe not. We'll maybe just say not. It's 20.
20 yeah. is enough.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's say 20.
Do you know what? I found that out because I did go to the maximum layers.
You went up to 20?
And I wanted more layers. I couldn't have any more layers.
So yeah, Guillaume, it's a good point. Like, to use Illustrator Draw, you don't have necessarily to work with the Apple Pencil. It can work with any kind of pencil, it can work with your finger. On Android, iOS, I would say that the Apple Pencil maybe provides more precision.
Yes, comfort. It's very nice, yeah.
But if you look at the work of Brian Yap, which is another artist using Illustrator Draw, or Rob Generate the Third,
God, Rob's at it every day.
Robzilla. Every day.
Every day.
New illustration on Instagram.
It's great stuff, yeah.
And he started without the Apple Pencil.
Without it?
Oh, without, yeah. He started with a classic pencil.
Yeah, definitely check out both of those. Brian and Rob, fantastic stuff. Definitely showing the some of the things you can do.
So he will be at Adobe Max too. So because within 2 weeks we will have Adobe Max, the creativity conference, huge conference in San Diego. Dan will be with me in California to attend the conference and also as a speaker. The good news is that for the first time we will be live streaming from Adobe Max. Yeah. So we will have a live stream booth. It will be live on adobelive.com, and we will welcome artists such as Dan and Robzilla will be there.
Yep.
So I'm sure he will be live with us. Maybe Brian Yap too, so you will see more illustrators. So to be notified when we will release this stream, make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. It's at the bottom of the player, okay? Below the player, click on subscribe. and you would be notified when the Adobe Max starts. So it would be on November 2nd, yeah. November 2nd, 3rd, and 4th.
Yeah.
Yeah, usually it starts on, Adobe Max starts on a Monday, but this year it starts on a Wednesday.
It's Wednesday, yeah.
Very confusing. Someone was asking also about the brushes you use in Photoshop.
Yeah.
And if you use specific brushes, if you use a Caris brush.
Do you know what? I use the most basic.
The default one? Yeah.
Default one, yeah.
The dot brush.
Because all I do is put. I've got the pressure sensitivity up really high, and generally I work at. I work at 400 dpi or higher. Yeah. On a canvas of maybe 18 by 24 inches, which is the standard like print size. And so it's generally just I work at a really high resolution and the most basic brush ever, but it works really well for me. And it's essentially
so
the
not
same
even
as this.
Specific settings.
No.
Just because they're asking, can you give us your settings?
No, that's no the setting. Thing. No, there's nothing. There's
open
no,
Photoshop and start drawing. Open no, Illustrator draw, start drawing.
There's no real trick, unfortunately. it's one of those things. If I do a tutorial, it is just I draw.
Yeah. Open Photoshop.
Drawing. Yeah. I mean, I would say one other thing is reference material. Reference materials is always really good, especially if you have something specific in mind you want to achieve with the illustration. Mm-hmm. With this, it's quite. I'm quite familiar with the various things we're drawing in this, so, you know, I can kind of just do it from memory.
Okay.
And also, it's very sort of organic, broken down things where nothing has to be specifically in place. You know, you can have, you can't. There's no wrong way to draw a broken bit of scenery.
Yeah,
for a tree.
That's it. No one will tell you.
Yeah, no one's gonna.
Branch is not at the right place.
Exactly. Yeah. So there we go. I think that front part's looking quite nice now. So I might move on to the top.
So for the people in the chat, let me ask you a question. So I will display a poll asking you, so you will see it very soon. If you're a member of Creative Cloud, if you are not, stay with us and participate in the online contest. So on adobelive.com, there is a contest tab on the right side panel, and you will discover the rules. Basically, we just ask you to create an illustration animation based on the theme Max and share it on Twitter or Instagram. We will select the top 10 entries. So we'll have 10 winners of 1 year Creative Cloud subscriptions.
It's pretty good.
Oh, which means everything Creative Cloud you have access to.
Yeah.
Photoshop, Illustrator, After Effects, I mean, all the video apps, all the graphic design apps, web apps. Plus the Creative Cloud services. So yeah, make sure to participate. And also it's an opportunity to share your art with our guests. So we will also display some entries during the live stream. So Dan can
I'd love to see
give some critique. So yeah. And if you want to share, not participate in the contest, but if you're an illustrator and you just have nice illustrations in your portfolio, make sure to share them also on Twitter. Just add the Adobe Live hashtag and maybe ask, in the tweet, asking Dan to review your art.
Yeah, we can do that, definitely.
He'll be happy to do it. I mean, usually he's very nice and friendly, but...
Today I have to be. I don't have a choice right now. You know. Yeah, maybe I could be really harsh. Maybe... No, I wouldn't do that. I'm too nice. I couldn't do that.
How dare you?
You really like that, don't you? Okay.
So actually, I will start monitoring the Adobe Live hashtag on my screen. I think it's a good idea. Actually. It can help. Yeah. Okay. Oh, and someone says on Twitter that the Adobe Live UI is sleek.
It is.
It's good, right?
Slick, yeah. Slick.
Yeah, okay. Because I'm learning new words, you know.
Slick's a good one.
Slick is, okay.
Slick works, yeah.
With you, what
I would say you're quite slick.
I learned tacky.
Tacky?
Tacky.
That's bad.
Techie is bad, Slick is good.
You're Techie.
And you taught me another one. It was Slacky or...
Slacky?
No?
I don't know which one you mean.
I mean, I remember in Barcelona you taught me another one.
Oh, I was thinking of Free Willy.
No, Free Willy was very confusing. Okay, so I have to tell you this story. Okay, so we were talking, and I tell him, like, what I really like with your art and the way you create is that you are free-willing. Okay. And then he didn't get it because of my accent. He got Free Willy, like the movie, you know, with the whale.
What a movie.
But just just to share with you that how nice Dan is that he didn't say anything.
I
so he's like, okay, Free Willy. Well, so he had the whale, you know, in mind and said, okay, yeah, thanks. Thanks for the feedback. And then yeah. 15 minutes after.
It took a while, yeah.
Took a while. Oh, Free Willing. Oh my
it's
God.
close, but not quite right. I'm sorry.
So funny.
You're right. I'm too nice. Now I'd just be like, what the hell are you talking about?
Oh God, that was good.
Okay, so I've moved up to the top now.
So Jessica, I know that when I pronounce winners, I know it sounds weird. I've learned it on previous streams. When I say winners...
Why are you saying that? Why are you saying winners? Oh, winners! Oh my God.
Okay, it's coming again. You see? It's not my fault.
Winners.
It's my mouth. It's my education. So how should I pronounce it? Okay, teach me. Because you... Another mistake I used to make when you say, okay, you can win signed prints and we will ship it to you. And I would say sheep, you know, like the animal.
Yeah, yeah.
But I don't know, I have to say ship it, like super fast.
Yeah, that's good.
So is it the same for winners? How should I say it?
Winners.
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 There you go.
Winners.
you're still doing this.
Winners.
You're saying it too sexily. You gotta.
Yeah. Practicing my English. Winners.
Winners.
I hope you will be one of the winners of the
there you go.
Of the Adobe Life contest.
I like the way you do it originally. You should stay that.
Okay, I will stick to it.
Winners.
Yeah, I'm French, so that's why even. There is an accent. So some words are really hard to pronounce for me. Really hard.
I think I'd rather have a French accent than a nondescript London nothing.
I have Sardich.
It's just nothing.
Sardich accent.
Yeah.
So Jonathan Buck, first time I've heard of Adobe Draw. Oh, good. So yeah, I mean Adobe Draw has been created. It's part of the Creative Cloud mobile apps, a suite of apps really designed for mobile devices. So even the UI, I mean, look at the UI.
It's very simple.
Yeah. Very simple. You can access all the tools just with simple tabs. And the idea is that you can start drawing anytime, anywhere, on your phone, actually. I remember there was someone in the chat using Adobe Draw on his phone and or on a tablet. You start sketching or you create a real illustration. And at the end, you say send to Photoshop or send to Illustrator. And boom, you get the file. Mm.
Yeah, I've not tried it on my phone. I want to try that. It's too tiny.
Yeah, I know, it's tiny. You will go... Actually... we have a Rufus bragging. What was the word like? Bragging off?
Yeah, bragging.
Showing off.
Showing off, yeah.
Because he has the iPhone 7.
Oh, is that the Plus. iPhone 7?
Plus.
Wow.
So he can use...
How are your headphones? Have you lost them already? Whatever.
Okay, so what are you working on?
We're doing some top trees now. Okay. So
if you just joined the stream, this is a sketch.
Mm. Well, there's our sketch.
The sketch, like you passed like 15 minutes on the sketch?
15, 20 minutes, yeah.
15, 20 yeah. minutes. And now you have 6 hours, 2 hours per day, because Dan will be live with us also tomorrow and on Thursday.
Yep.
To achieve the illustration, make it look great, and we will give away signed prints.
And that's we'll the idea.
Ship the prints to you. Just ship it.
Gonna ship it to the wieners.
Jonathan is asking and realizing that you don't use art gloves, you know, like the gloves. Using.
I do for the Cintiq.
Yeah. Cintiq, yeah.
And actually, it's the sort of thing that would be quite useful on here for like over an hour, because it gets quite hot. So it's actually happening to me right now. The glove would be good right now. It's that if for anyone that hasn't seen it, it covers just your two fingers down here, and it sort of means you can slide all over the place. And that's it's really good, really useful. Everyone makes fun of it in my studio. They think it's my sexy magician glove.
Magic
yes,
tricks.
Like that. Hey. But in reality, it does make drawing on a screen like really a lot easier.
So we have a good question by Surrender asking, how can I import this these drawings to Illustrator? Well,
I'll show you with one tab.
Boop. Send to Illustrator.
There we go.
So how does it work? Because oh, this is a magic trick, by the way.
Exactly.
This is because Dan is using Illustrator CC, Creative Cloud. So if you use the same Adobe ID, okay, he can say send to Illustrator, and the next time he will open his desktop computer or his laptop, because he signed in with the same Adobe ID, it will launch Illustrator and open the drawing.
Yeah, it's pretty instantaneous as well.
Yeah, very fast. Okay, Shiva, you tweeted your work, that's fine. You don't have to say it three times in the chat. Don't worry. I will get it. Okay. I will go on Twitter, I will find it. Don't worry. Okay, okay. So, let me go to full screen so we can show it to our friends.
Yeah.
So we invited you to share your art on social, so on Twitter and on Instagram using the Adobe Live hashtag. So there are two ways. Either you create an original illustration or animation based on the theme Max, then you can get a chance to win Creative Cloud. But if you just want also to share your art, I mean, for the creative community, and have Dan just give some critique or feedback on the art, I mean, it's the right time. So let me display this beauty here. So Dan, we have Tapli Yal Shivam sharing this.
It's very nice. There's a lot. That is making me instantly think of the mouth from Alien. The snapping jaws.
Yeah.
Yeah. I like that. Yeah. It's a lot of nice movement going on in
there. Nice job.
Some nice highlighting as well. Yeah, really
nice.
So
we have also some works by Tristan. Well, look at that.
Wow.
Normally do printmaking. This is my third attempt. Thanks to Dan, you inspired me through...
Plymouth Uni, I think that might be.
Yeah,
let's go with that.
Plymouth Uni, yeah.
Hey, that's really cool. That's in intensely detailed.
Oh my God, yeah.
Yeah. That must have taken a long time to do.
And look at the...
Oh, yeah. That's great.
We're inside. That's... We're live streaming from this. And another one by Tristan. Thanks for sharing your art. I mean,
yeah, these are lovely.
It's really great. So he designed a spinning wheel.
Oh, dear. Come on. We'll come back to that in a second.
And there is Daniel. Okay, let's try it. Okay, Daniel.
Wow.
Oh, illustration for an album cover. Love to know your thoughts.
I think that's going to make a really, really nice album cover.
Wow.
Yeah. I would say whatever happens with the type, don't overdo it. That needs some really simple
Now type. With some colors.
Yeah, that's lovely.
Wow.
I would say simple type.
Simple type?
Yeah, something simple, centered, maybe down the bottom.
Okay.
Don't go over the top with it. If you can, which is my favorite thing to do, dependent on the record label, a sticker for the type. No type whatsoever.
Oh,
on it, and
sticker.
It's a sticker. Yeah.
Oh, nice.
I've done that with a few records, and you know, you have the name down the side and maybe on the back, but not on the actual cover. And I think you can probably get away with that more now that records aren't resold in the shops. You know, I don't think it's necessarily that important.
Good point.
It's, you know, it, but that is the artist versus the brand and management in that situation. I think the band will probably go along with you, but the people with the money probably won't agree with that.
So Andre Bertello is asking, will there be a Premiere Pro or After Effects stream? So within about 3 hours, we will welcome James Curran. So you can check the schedule on AdobeLive.com. And James Curran works in After Effects. He creates crazy animations.
Yeah.
And at the end becomes an infinite loop, MAT GIF, that you can share on the web. So the Acorn People is asking, whose album artwork have you done?
Who have I done? Well, the first one and probably most popular one I did was Gallows. That was, I did a lot of branding and album artwork for them, along with a designer called Alex White with the first one, and then it got relaunched, so re-released, and I did that. Along with some EPs, that stuff's, as far as music covers go, I think that's probably what I'm best known for doing. Then I worked with a band called Protest the Hero not long ago. That was a good one. Parkway Drive did their album Deep Blue. I've done lots, and yet my mind's going very blank right now. I haven't done a lot of music covers in the last 3 or 4 years. I haven't really done that many, but I did. For about 5 years, I probably did a good 50 or so album covers in total. Lots of fun. It's always really good fun, especially if you do the whole package as well. But it's, not so much in the last few years, unfortunately. Oh, another good one was Evil Nine. I did a...
Evil Nine.
Yeah, they're...
I like the name.
They're...
Because Evil Eight?
No.
Kind of bad, but Evil Nine...
Forget them. Evil Nine, they did. They're an electronic group. I can't remember what genre specifically it is. I'm not very good with that style of music. But we did 3 EPs essentially on vinyl, and all of the covers made up a gigantic zombie landscape with the 2 band members at the front of it leading it. So if you look up Evil Nine, I think it was called They Live. I can't remember. We did some really good, that was really, really fun artwork.
And I guess you have a friend in the chat, Jared, asking, how can you forget A Day to Remember?
He's right. I did A Day to Remember. Yeah, that was... Okay, yeah, that's probably... A Day to Remember, a very big band. And I worked on... I think it was their 2nd album. And that was... Yeah, that was a very, very popular record. Yeah. Sorry. Yeah, my mind went a bit blank. I'm a little bit under the weather today. You've got to forgive me. My mind's all over the place.
Thanks.
But yes, that is good thinking.
PR.
Yeah. Yeah, if you've got any others, tell me. Black Dahlia Murder.
Katy Perry. Yeah.
No, not Katy Perry. Again, we've got to leave that one alone. She doesn't want people to know about that. I did a lot of work with the band The Black Dahlia Murder. I did around 25 t-shirts for them. Yeah, like, they're really, really, really fun, very, very, very heavy metal band, but, like, the nicest guys, and they always came to me with these really, really cool sort of ideas of horror icons reimagined, you know, Frankenstein, Dracula, that sort of thing.
Nice.
But it got to the point where we were reimagining really old 70s horror movies that, you know, no one except for the band had heard of and stuff like that.
They're all talking about Homesick. So are you Homesick or is it a band?
That's the Homesick's the A Day to Remember album cover.
That's why. So these are not like people in the chat being Homesick.
Well, they might be.
Maybe they might be. Maybe there's a connection.
The interesting thing about that album cover was it was, I think it was their 2nd album. maybe the third, but they were really on like a really really big rise, and they asked me to hide these little symbols in the artwork. And
like Easter eggs.
Yeah. So as you look around it was a big landscape piece, and as you looked around it, there are these really weird symbols. And I think as the album was coming out and afterwards, they put out messages with those little symbols in them, and it was like a code for people to work things out. So it was a really, it was a really fun project to work on, because there's a lot of mystery around it, you know. Someone's saying, "What key?" Go and look at the album cover, and you'll see it. there's weird symbols in there, and they mean something. I don't know what. I never found out. They just told me what to do, if you will.
So you know what? This is the top of the hour, and I made a promise. We'll give away one signed print.
Just one.
Just one for the moment. To one of you in the chat, and this will be the final illustration, not this stage, otherwise it would be lame.
You could have this if you want.
Yeah, we can have a branch, some trees.
I'll give you
some roots.
Just that.
Thanks, Dan.
It will be
the final one. So how to enter the contest? It's super easy. You just have to, we are talking about keys and stuff. You just have to type a keyword in the chat. So make a sentence with this keyword, and the keyword is illustrator, okay? Starting now. So just write a sentence, just put illustrator inside to be eligible.
I thought you were gonna come to me for the keyword then. I thought I was gonna have to come up with something on the spot. You panicked me.
No, just illustrator in the chat. Just say something with Illustrator in the chat. I will show you. Something like, I love Illustrator. Okay, now it's starting.
I like Illustrator.
Okay, now you're eligible, and we will...
You're a dope illustrator, that's a good one.
We will run a script.
What's the cast?
Actually, you know the name of the script? It's called Nightbot. Actually, it's a bot. His name is Nightbot, and Nightbot will pick someone in the chat, you see? Here. It's building a list.
Look at that.
Yeah, it's coming. It's coming. So we give you 2 minutes.
It's fun.
10 minutes, and then I will roll it, and Nightbot will choose a winner. The winner.
You'll get there one day.
One day. We get the lucky one.
There you go. That works.
Yeah, it works.
The lucky wiener. I'm sorry, I'm not going to stop now.
Okay, we have some very good sentences using Illustrator. That's nice. Thanks for playing the game. Okay, so I will press the button and the name will appear in the chat. Okay, and the winner is John Clark. John Clark, congratulations. Woo! Congratulations, John.
What did he say, I wonder?
Let me find it.
Better not be offensive.
He said, Illustrator is integral to my workflow. Oh, it was a nice one.
It's a nice one.
Good job, Nightbot. So John, Rufus will contact you in the chat. Make sure to stay in touch with Rufus. And congratulations, you will give us your information and we will send you a signed print. That's cool. So stay with us because during this show we will give away another one. Anytime, another one. And now you got it. I mean, it's super easy. Just be with us. And look at the chat, so friendly. They say congratulations, John. Nice job. Yeah.
That's nice.
That's so nice.
Yeah. Such friendly bunch of people.
You would be so pissed. Yeah. I mean, I know you. You would be like, oh no, not John.
I'd get kicked out.
How?
I'd be trolling everyone.
Mm.
Oops.
So, John, yeah, check the chat. Rufus is talking to you. Okay, so we're still together for about... you have 45 minutes, my friend.
45 minutes?
Yeah, plenty of time.
Okay, well, yeah, we're getting there. I think today we're probably going to get most of the foreground done. Then tomorrow we'll get into the background elements, I think. I don't know. I'm just going to keep going on these bits.
We still have friends like sharing their artwork on Twitter, so you can review the work. And we have one from Only One Next. From the X Love Save. Okay, whatever. What do you think? Brutal honesty, please.
Don't be shy. Brutal. Oh, she said brutal honesty.
Yeah. This is a 4-color screen print.
I think that's really impressive for a 4-color screen print.
Yeah.
I am not someone that can... I don't do much stuff with gradients and things like that. So, you know, if you can pull that off when printed, that's really cool.
Hmm.
I think you've got some nice compositional stuff going on there. Nice symmetry. Nice placement of text. I think it's a very well thought out piece, if I'm honest. Yeah. I think that's really good.
Hmm.
Good work.
Yeah.
Keep going.
Good work, yeah. Yeah, it's amazing. Thanks for... and I see you in the chat now. Exclusive Co. Thanks for sharing your art. And not being shy, because, we...
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you sure are in front of all the people in the chat, so good job. And if you want to... now they start talking about it in the chat, so yeah. If you want also to give some nice feedback to Exclusive Co. I mean, that's the spirit of this creative community, so that's great.
Got to stick together.
Okay, good. So, still working on this tree?
Still going.
Okay.
Sorry. Doesn't make for very interesting viewing right now.
Oh, no, that's fine. They ask interesting questions, so...
It'll get more exciting.
And you always start with the dark? Yeah.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
I find it's a lot easier to work on what is essentially the, like, key line art, mm-hmm. because then everything sort of falls in nicely behind it. It's definitely a lot easier to do it that way.
So, Valentin, yeah, I guess you try to share a link. Don't share links in the chat, please. Use Twitter and the Adobe Live hashtag. That's how we communicate with our speakers. Gamer for Life, yes. Welcome. And that's good, because now there is a conversation going on between them, you know.
Perfect.
Now they are talking to a specific
person. They don't
really care thing. About us.
Sorry, yeah. you guys carry on. Don't worry.
Hi, Taeyong.
We'll be here.
Taeyong Jung is asking, is it the iPad Pro? Yes. So today, yeah. Dan is working with the iPad Pro using Illustrator Draw, a free application that you can download on the App Store. And also an Android on the Google Play Market.
So what I'm doing now, actually, is I'm starting to work on another layer.
Okay, so you create a new one?
Just create another layer. And what we're doing here is I'm going to add in, if I just get rid of the ruler, there's a slightly darker line work layer on top.
Okay.
So I'm just going to add that in. Just adds a little bit more
depth.
A little bit more depth, yeah. So there we go.
And Cedric is saying, I know what would make it even more exciting, animating that smoke. Yeah, that would be nice. Yeah.
Well,
we can ask James.
You do have an animator next. Yeah. So
next we'll be with Mara Grinlund in 1 hour, and then with James Curran, who is an animator working in After Effects. I already did a stream with James. So that's funny, is that when he comes, he has no plan in mind.
Yeah, he said that, yeah.
And it's the same today. Like, he has no plan in mind. So be with us, because he will be very receptive to your suggestions. So if you type, I don't know, like sausage and eagle in the chat, he will find an animation. He will find something.
Yeah, I'm sorry I couldn't be quite as free. I need a plan.
Yeah.
I'd have panicked otherwise. Yeah.
He has a free-willing creative process.
Exactly. Thank you. You got it in there properly.
Okay, Jimmy, thanks for posting your art on Twitter. I will get back to Twitter in 5 minutes. Can you tell us more about the background? So I guess Moonland is asking about this drawing. So this is an illustration that Dan is working on over 3 days. Okay, so 2 hours today, 2 hours same time tomorrow, and also on Thursday. So make sure to get the full schedule on adobelive.com. And he's working on this illustration. So what you see here is just a sketch that he did in 15, 20 minutes about this girl in a lost city after the apocalypse. So, and you still need to find the title. And now he's working on the details. Yeah. And this will become a final print that we are giving away to 6 people. 6 lucky people. Lucky winners.
So yeah, I'm kind of repeating the process a little bit of what I was just doing. Mm-hmm. But
so with the lines near, just to keep the angle.
Yeah, yeah. So it's all going the same sort of direction.
Hmm.
So slowly gonna, we're slowly building it up, but I think it should come together quite nicely. See how
Luke has a good title for you. This is Dude, Where Is My Spaceship? Yeah, she's like very lost.
She is. See, the thing with draw is you can get really close in and kind of get lost a little bit in the details.
Mm-hmm.
Got to be careful. You don't want to spend too long zoomed in on something.
So Charles is asking, how did you quickly call up that ruler tool? So to display the ruler. Yeah. So it's at the top.
It's the shapes up at the top, and you've got these just some basic shapes. And curves and polygons. I think there's a few other things as well down there. The ruler tool is pretty cool. It's just spin it around and it locks into 90 degree angles.
Can you extend the width of the? I'm not sure.
No, I don't know that you can. Oh, there you go.
Yeah, there.
Oh, is that? Just making it larger?
I don't know. Yeah, you can make it larger.
Well, there you go. Yeah. So you got lots of... That's a really cool tool just to sort of make perfect lines if you want to, which I often do.
So Anandu is asking, please teach us how to do the same with Illustrator. Well, what's funny is that when Dan is not working with Illustrator Draw on a tablet, he's working with Photoshop.
Yeah.
So you're not actually an Illustrator user.
No, not really. No, I
you know the basics, but you.
Yeah, I use it for I use it for things occasionally.
Mm.
You know, obviously sometimes things need to be in Illustrator.
Yeah.
But it's not. It's just not the. It's not where I learnt to create work in the way I do, I guess. So it's it's never really been. Being where I make my work, but it works equally as well. You know, I could do it that way if I wanted. I guess I like Photoshop.
Do you design some logos sometimes?
Not really. I have done a few. Yeah.
For bands also.
Yeah, a few band logos obviously my own stuff. It's not something I, you know, when it comes to stuff like that, I feel that there are people that are better at it than me. Like I like to do stuff that's, you know, landscapes and things like that. So I tend to, that's one of those things where I would often just sort of say, you know what, there's someone that can do that better than me, probably. But if and it's if it's needed, yeah.
So by the way, next in 45 minutes, we will have another guest, Mara Grönlund. She's an artist from Denmark. And I think she will teach us how to create logos in Illustrator just using geometric shapes. So it would make sense. And people in the chat, okay, if you just joined, make sure to subscribe to the YouTube channel because this is one of the best ways to be notified when there is a new live stream. And also, within 2 weeks, there will be Adobe Max, huge conference with hours of live streams, including the keynote, which is the biggest Adobe event of the year, with where we will reveal what's coming next, you know, the strategy and stuff. It's really amazing with amazing guests. So to make sure to be notified when the keynote will be streamed, subscribe to the YouTube channel, okay? It's below the player. If you're on adobelive.com, it's at the bottom of the UI. So Mohamed is asking, so you're not into branding? No, he's not.
Not really, no.
No.
But, you know, I appreciate good branding. But that's a different thing.
Pen, pineapple, apple pen. Yeah, yeah, Jared. We know this that video.
Okay.
My son was actually singing this yesterday.
I don't know that. What is it?
Pen, pineapple, apple pen.
You don't know this? I don't know that. No, what's that?
Oh my god. Okay. Just Google it. You won't be disappointed.
Okay.
It's an amazing artist. Ooh, yeah. It's a great song.
Okay.
Very graphic. Adobe Max hype. Yes, Cedric. Oh, let's check. Okay. Let me create a poll. Where is it? Poll. Okay. New one, Adobe Max, and I will ask you if you are going to Max. And I will broadcast. Display the poll right now. This is a good thing with this new UI. Now you can directly engage with us.
Yeah, it's really cool.
So if you can just say yes or no. And I can see the results. Okay, it's definitely a no.
What's that?
Like 95%.
Oh.
But you're very lucky because this year we will live stream, we'll be live from Adobe Max for the first time. Live on YouTube.
That's cool.
With more than 20 guests over 3 days. It would be intense. It would be a little bit like at UF in Barcelona. Mm. Remember, like every hour a new guest.
That was intense.
It was intense. And we were like surrounded by people. Mm. Was it with you when we had some people asking questions about where are the toilets? Or
you don't remember? No, we had someone come on and ask what the Wi-Fi password was. That was good. That's, yeah. She was nice.
So Kate Church is asking, how do you turn off layers so quickly?
Oh. It's just on the side. You just double tap.
You double tap on the layer. That's the shortcut.
Yeah. Yeah, it's all very
So, okay, Kyle, do you ever come to Spain? Yeah, I mean, Dan and I, we were in Barcelona in May.
May.
And we'll probably be back, I guess, next year in Barcelona.
It's a good place.
Yeah, it's a place to be. We have Leo from Colombia, South America. Who is from South America in the chat? Colombia, we had some people from Brazil. Okay, let's see if we have the five continents. Okay, just type your if you're from Europe, Africa, Asia, Australia, and the islands, North America or South America? North Pole, South Pole.
You want to get the full house, from, you want everything.
From Paul Trini. Okay, we have Brazil. Okay. So Brazil, Peru. Okay. So we have South America, Italy. We have Europe covered. Indonesia. Okay. It's covered. We have Antarctica. Okay, good, Josh.
Wow. Yeah.
Good job. Korea. So we have Asia. Russia. Okay, that's good. What is missing? Do we have someone from Africa? Please. Come on, Africa. Nigeria, we got it.
Full house.
Worldwide live stream. That's the creative community. That's what I like. And no, Alex, I won't pronounce it. You wanted to trick me. With the name of the planet. You want to see the planet? Here.
Oh, for God's sake.
Ah, no.
Get out, Alex.
Good trick. Good trick, Alex.
Okay.
Okay, Canada, Malaysia. Must be very late in Malaysia. No? Almost midnight, I guess. Brexit land. Yeah, this is coming.
Yeah. That was stupid.
Oh, Senegal. Okay, we have another friend in Africa. That's good. I want to go back to Senegal. India. Ah, nice. And Korea. Cool. I have to go back to Korea too. So nice.
Okay, so now.
Okay, so how many layers do we have so far?
We got two layers.
Two
so
layers,
far.
Okay.
And what I'm gonna do is start to throw a few highlights. Just. I'm not gonna go crazy on this one because we haven't got too much time. So I'm just going to do a few little, like, pick out a few bits that will, when we've got more color in there, it's sort of, it'll make it look a bit more alive.
Well, okay. So Kate Church is asking, did you draw the pink background? Yes, he did.
Yeah.
In 15 minutes. So that's the first sketch, and now he's working on the final illustrations with more details.
Yeah.
So... the sketch for you, what is it? It's already the structure, I guess, the composition?
Yeah, it's...
the concept?
It's a way for me to sort of work out if the idea works and get the color and structure in place. Okay. And I always sort of think if you can make something work in a messy way like that and sort of squint and look at it and go... that's going to work as a composition,
mm-hmm.
Then it's, you know, it's going to be worth spending lots of time on, essentially. Mm-hmm. I think a good sketch is important because you can make mistakes then, you know, and you can work out what color something should be or anything like that. And, you know, I still make changes afterwards when something is finished, but it's a lot easier to change it at the start if you can. So yeah, that's another tip. Sketches, do a good sketch. Always helps a lot.
And Anne is asking, do you always use solid colors or sometimes you play with the opacity?
It depends. A lot of stuff I do is for screen printing.
Yeah.
So in that respect, you know, it's got to be solid to an extent.
Okay.
But there might be some sort of gradient stuff with half-toning, things like that. But generally, I use solid color.
Screen printing, maybe you can explain how this works. Yeah. Because I guess we have some designers who are not familiar with the technique.
I'm just trying to think if there's a good way for me to show on here, actually. I don't think I've got anything on here. But essentially,
You have it on your website, and maybe I can share
it. Yeah, if we bring up something on. Hey, do you know what? I think there's a video. Could we play that?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Yeah. So if we go to about. Well, there's a video. There's a video here that's is 10 minutes long. We won't play the whole thing, but.
Well, maybe I can skip to.
Yeah, I think the relevant parts. Maybe 8 minutes in. Round here. Yes, okay. This is the perfect point. So, screen printing is essentially the process of printing an image on white paper or a coloured paper in a limited amount of colours. So the image the print you're seeing here being made was for the film Nosferatu.
Oh, yeah.
So basically you start with your white paper, we're putting down the lightest colour.
Oh, lightest first.
Lightest first. You don't have to do it that way. Maybe you do. I mean, it depends what you're trying to achieve with the print. Okay. But generally you're going from lightest to darkest and you're printing on top of those colours below. So as we can see, basically this is it's slowly darker greys essentially in this situation, this is a good example of pretty much how most of my work gets done.
Okay.
Nearly everything I do ends up as a screen print, something like this. There you go. Yeah, that's it. Finished print.
But so how hard is it for a printer? Like to, it takes time for the printer
to do the
layers.
I mean, it depends on the print. Something like that. I went down. I was there for that print process for that film, and we did that in a day.
Okay.
Maybe it was 100 prints. It's probably like a 5-hour process, something like that. But then you have to prepare the screens that you're printing on as well. That's a whole thing, and there's quite a few different skills that go into it. Things that I'm not very good at, hence why I don't screen print my own work. But yeah, I would. That's a good video.
Yeah, that's great. And someone is asking, so do you? So you have to create each layer and then separate everything for the printer.
Yeah. Perhaps tomorrow, actually, I could bring in on my laptop. I've got files I could show of how.
Oh yeah, maybe
if people are interested, I could show that.
We can show that.
Because there is a quite specific way I set things up to go to print.
Oh yeah, maybe you can show it tomorrow on day three, you know, on Thursday.
Yeah, yeah. Well, day three, actually, because I'll have the laptop the up for that.
Yeah, let's do that.
But yeah, it's not a simple process of finishing the illustration in layers and then going to print. It's more making sure things are ready for the printers and how the printers might want to receive the files. It's good to work with a printer that you trust and maybe knows your work.
Mm-hmm.
Also, you have to think about things like choosing Pantone colors. You know, there's a lot of different things that go into screen printing that you don't necessarily think about at first. But yeah, it's a fun process. It's not quick, but at the end of it, you sort of feel like you've got something really worthwhile and probably not to be reproduced as well. So it's good.
Okay, so there we are. So we invited our friends to share some art on Twitter using the Adobe Live hashtag. So you can review the work. So look at this one. It's by Alexa Rico. Really love your work. Would be great if you comment my poster for Carpenter Brut. Thank you.
I really like that.
Wow. And that?
Yeah, that's really cool. That's, is that a screen? I wonder if it's a screen print.
Could be, no?
Yeah. If that's not a screen print, it looks like something that would be a screen print. I think that's really cool. That's a very nicely stylized image, and the use of that must be a screen print. If it's not, that should be, because I could see that being that's a very good example of using limited color palette to achieve a lot in an image with all the shading and stuff going on there. Yeah, very nicely done.
Cool. And we have Dorian, so he's using, I guess, drawn on the iPad mini.
Hey!
That's nice.
Yeah, that's really cool. On the iPad mini as well. Not got much surface to work on.
But no.
Nicely done, yeah.
And this one too. Oh, with the lettering and stuff. Whoa.
Well, you're a...
iPad Mini 2. Nice.
Yeah, you're a better person than me. I'm rubbish with type. I can't do anything.
Look
like
at the
that
rope and stuff.
Yeah.
That's nice.
That's really nice. That's the sort of thing I could see working really well in Draw, actually.
Yeah.
If it wasn't done in there. Because it, you know, that it has a very slight assist with the drawing.
Mm-hmm.
Sort of helping you with your curves and your lines. It's quite useful, especially with mobile, because, you know, if you're on the move. Oops.
Thank you for reviewing my work. I mean, you're welcome. And if you want to share your work, just use the Adobe Live hashtag. Also, there is an opportunity for you to win Creative Cloud subscriptions. Create an illustration or an animation based on the theme Max and share it also on Twitter or Instagram using the Adobe Live hashtag. If you want to check the rules of this contest, it's on adobelive.com. Look at on the right in the side panel, there is a contest tab with all the rules. And we will select the top 10 entries, and the designers will get 1 year Creative Cloud subscriptions.
It's a pretty good prize.
So we have someone joining. Is it Stalactit? Nice graphic designer. What are they doing? We have Dan with us.
What are they doing?
What they doing, Jude? Working on illustration on the iPad Pro with Illustrator Draw. He had 3 days, so he started with the sketch, and now he's working on the dark.
Yeah, we're getting the nice...
And some highlights.
Yeah.
Very so nice.
Yeah, we're very close to being done.
Should be done on Thursday. If you come back with us on Thursday, and we will give away more prints. Actually, stay with us, because within 15 minutes, more or less, we will give away another signed print by Dan Mumford.
We will.
Oh, yeah, we will. In 15 minutes.
Okay. Come on.
If you want to know more about Dan, if you just join also on adobelive.com, on the right, you will notice a speakers tab, and there is a link to his portfolio. So, another question. So, do you finance the right word? The work outside of the app? So, once you're done, usually you send it to Photoshop, right?
Yes, yeah. Normally, I'll do that to just tweak colors or, you know, just or crop things down or something like that.
Okay.
It just sort of finalize things.
And you keep the separate layers.
Yes.
So that's, that's the beauty of it.
Yeah. If something's going to screen print as well, there's sort of a few quite fiddly things that I need to do to prepare the print file, like add trap. I won't go into the details. There's lots of boring things you need to do when sending something to screen print. So I just play around with that in Photoshop as well. And choosing Pantone colors as well, that sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
Always best to do that in a room with natural light and not on your iPad screen out in sunlight. That doesn't work at all.
That doesn't work.
No.
So, Sung Park from Korea is asking, so does the word Max have to be in the artwork? It doesn't have to be inside, it has to inspire you. And maybe in the tweet you can explain, you know. I don't know, maybe Max is the name of your cat. So you draw your cat. Maybe
good cat name.
Maybe you want to express that you are at the top of your game, like the Max, you know? I don't know, I mean...
Yeah, that works.
Find a way. Rufus? That's a lot of going on.
All right. So... We've got quite a... There we go. So that's looking quite nice and layered now.
Show me the highlights.
It's hard to see with the light in here. They're there. I'm looking at the screen over there.
It's easier here.
The other thing is, it's quite hard to appreciate like the highlights I'm doing at the moment, but when it's cropped down and we don't have like the white border and everything, everything become, you know, your the way the light corrects things makes it look a bit different. But that's why I do the sketch. Like I trust in my sketch that I chose the right colors beforehand. Even if something looks a bit wrong now, I know that when everything else is in there, it's all gonna sort of fall together.
Interesting.
In theory. You know, sometimes things go wrong. Okay. Just gonna add a little bit up here. How are we doing on time?
On time, okay. So we're on 15 minutes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So yeah, we'll be done with the foreground today, I think, and then that means tomorrow we can move on to the maybe the smoke, I think. I think it's smoke tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe if I've got time. You'll notice I haven't touched the lady there.
And
that's because it's the one bit you want to get right. Do I want to do it? You know, don't want to leave it to last. I don't know.
Oh, maybe.
Maybe.
Maybe
I'm
day
know.
Three, yeah?
Yeah, maybe I'll do it right at the end. Or I won't do it at all. No, you need the lady there. She adds something. But people, like, I can get trees wrong. It doesn't really matter.
Yeah, but the people.
But people, you need that
like
to look.
Three legs.
Yeah. It's really tough, that. Faces. That you'll notice I will never draw a face on a live stream, because it's very easy to get a face wrong. Maybe
what did you do last time? It was a skull, right? Yeah, it was a skull.
Yeah, it was like with some branches coming out of it. And yep. then afterwards with Rufus, I did one in a Bump Festival, and I did a floating island. That was quite fun.
And we have Muhammad in the chat who is using Illustrator Draw now. He's asking, where is the color picker? He cannot find it.
Oh, okay. So on the side, if you hold down color.
It's a long tap.
Yeah, just hold it, and eventually you get this magnifying glass.
I see.
And then you can just pick whatever color you want. It's very simple. Okay. Do you know what? We'll start to draw the lady. We've got to do it at some point. So what I will do. So I've got this shape which I'm fairly happy with. Just okay.
So we do another round of people sharing artworks.
Yeah, go for it.
We have a very good designer, Adam Forster. Look at that.
Hey, that's awesome.
Screen printed poster. As above, so below.
Yeah, I mean that's a perfect example of utilizing screen print in a good way.
He shared also this one, The Bride of Frankenstein.
Yeah, yeah, that's awesome. Like that's a good example of using halftone really well. I mean, I guess that's probably only three color or two, actually. I don't know. Might be three color, but that's, you know, you can do a lot of really clever stuff with halftone. Those are beautiful, really, really nice.
And we have Leo saying, hey, what's up? So he's working in a Illustrator. Nice.
He's done like a looks
some
like
symmetry.
The,
yeah,
looks like the Motorhead logo.
Yeah.
That's cool.
And Anne Cooper, so she's the one in the chat doing screen printing.
Yeah, that's really nice. That's crazy detailed.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's beautiful. Very nicely done.
And another one from Kenshin Kiba.
Whoa.
That's Mario style.
I
know you'll love this.
Yeah, I love that. That's really cool. A lot of weird stuff going on,
yeah.
Like the like that sort of cube
crows.
Shape. Yeah, that's cool. That's nice and that's out there. Are you Satan? That's a good comment, isn't it? What does that even mean? Yes, sure.
Yeah, sure. Okay, so thanks for sharing your art. You know what? We will give away now one more signed print by Dan. So let me explain how this works. you have to say something in the chat. Okay, type something and put Illustrator. This is the keyword in the sentence. Like Illustrator is amazing or whatever you want. Just put Illustrator in the sentence. Say something in the chat now, and within 3 minutes we'll have this screen running, this script, sorry, by Nightbot, and he will pick someone in the chat who will receive a signed print by Dan. So it's your turn now. Say something in the chat. And this is coming. Here we go.
It's going to be the same again. I love Illustrator. Yeah. Illustrator's great.
Someone is drawing like, Dan Mumford is my favorite illustrator.
But no, Nightbot, I'm not choosing.
Nightbot has no feeling, you know. So don't try to impress Nightbot.
There's a lot.
It's a robot.
One of the top 9,000 illustrators I know. I'm in the top 9,000. Wow. Woo. Yeah, I'll accept that. Yeah. Maybe I'll make the top 8,000 one day.
On my way to be an illustrator. That's a good one. Okay, I give you 1 minute and then we'll know who will receive the signed print, and the name will be displayed in the chat. Nightbot will write it down.
Nightbot. Why is it called Nightbot?
I don't know why. I don't know.
It's a good name.
It's a good name, but we don't know why.
Yeah.
The logo is weird though. See, that's the logo here.
Oh wow.
It's not that good.
Yeah. Okay, well, hey, it works.
It works, cool. It works. The chat is very creative today. Okay, so let's pick someone in the chat. Come on, Nightbot. And this is Valentin Kitschensky. Congratulations, Valentin.
But what did they
and
say?
And thanks for being with us. I can find it. I can find it. Illustrator, we all are into. Yeah.
Sure. Yeah.
It works.
Yeah.
It works. Good job, Valentin. So make sure to stay focused in the chat because Rufus will get in touch with you. And you will receive a signed print. I don't know when, so I won't. I'm not the kind of guy who will commit on date. Yeah, because we need to print stuff. I take some time and ship it.
You'll get it.
Also, it depends on your country. I mean, if you live in, we had people from all around the world today. Hey, that's not my name. No, sorry, Virginia. Maybe another time. Is there a way to find the others in the chat and connect? You have the names, so... But there is no way to directly send them a private message. No. No. So you're working on the girl now.
Very yeah. Brave. Yeah, well, I thought if we do it today, then tomorrow I can just draw some nice buildings or some smoke.
Buildings.
She looks okay. We got something there. Looks a little wonky.
So Michael Tamoni is asking how can he contact you about design for vinyl or like a disc.
Oh, vinyl.
Vinyl.
Oh, so as in to do a design for
I guess.
Email me. Yeah. Email.
Where is your email?
Well, you can contact me at danmumforddraws@gmail.com.
Mm-hmm.
Or all.
On your website, I
info's
guess.
On my website, yeah. Yeah. Everything's there, yeah.
Good.
Don't use Facebook or Twitter.
Yeah.
Like I get the messages, but it's so hard to keep on top of
yeah,
that stuff. Email's the way.
Valentin Rufus will talk to you.
Okay. So you'll notice I'm taking quite a lot of time on these little bits here, but this is
yeah, it's important.
It's fiddly stuff, yeah. But
and within 15 minutes we will welcome Marek Wilnan. So stay with us. If you're on Adobe Live, super easy, just stay on Adobe Live and we will switch to the new stream. If you're watching us on the YouTube website now, I will invite you to switch to the adobelive.com experience so you will have a seamless transition. Adam is saying, I wonder what he charges. Lol.
What I charge?
Yeah.
That's not something to be discussed.
No. And then Luke is saying he charges the iPad pencil so he can draw. Actually, it's a very expensive pencil. Yeah?
It is, yeah.
It's like, it is expensive. The most expensive pencil in a design career. I can tell you. Is this live stream can be watched later? Yes. So the replay will be available on Adobe Live. I will add a section on the website. But also, if you go to YouTube on our Creative Cloud channel, and there is a link at the bottom, the replay will be available, I guess, in 30 minutes, something like this. Just give the time to YouTube to process the video, and it will be available for sure.
All right. So I think we got quite a good start there today, actually.
Oh, look at that.
That's pretty much the foreground
okay. Done.
I think once the background elements are in there, though, what I'll be doing is I'll go back into the top to sort of add any highlights and things like that. But overall, that leaves us in a pretty good position to move on tomorrow to the more fun stuff in the background. That smoke will be fun to do, I think. Yeah.
Someone says, I am his manager, contact me for pricing. Did you know that you have a manager? That's new.
Josh Erickson, right, yeah. No, yeah. Not familiar with him, no.
No.
I do not contact Josh Erickson.
That's a smart move.
It's a smart move, yeah. Yeah. Could get work for free. See, already I'm looking around. There's lots of places I can add lots of detail. I'm just going to keep going until you tell me to stop.
Yeah, I mean, we still have like 6 minutes.
6 minutes.
Yep. 5 minutes before saying goodbye to our friends. By the way, if you like this interactive live stream where you can directly engage with the artist, make sure to like the video on YouTube. And yeah, we'll try to do more next year and have more and more guests. We'll try also if there is a specific topic you want to cover. So this week is more about illustration and animation, but if you want us to cover another creative field, just ask. Wow, we have someone joining from India.
Hello.
Thanks for joining. It's very late there.
Yeah.
And so stay with us. We are with Dan, but within 10 minutes we'll switch to another artist, Mara Grunland. She's from Denmark and she's an illustrator master. And she will actually teach us how to create logos with Illustrator, just starting with the basic geometric shapes. Okay. But she's very good. So everything looks simple with Maria, but It looks so good at the end. You want us to live stream every day? Well, well,
that'd be really, really tiring.
Yeah, it would be too much.
Yeah. You got another 6 hours of this.
Yeah,
I can go back to the hotel.
Yeah, I know what you're doing.
I'm gonna watch from my hotel bed. I'm gonna be in the chat. I'm gonna be saying really insulting things.
With a fake name.
Yes. I wouldn't do that. I will do that.
Oh, we have a Cecily saying, thank you for this, can't wait to see you tomorrow again. Yeah, so he will be back, same time, on adobelive.com. Make sure to be back.
Make sure to come back. It's going to get more interesting, a lot more fun.
Yeah.
I hope, like, people being able to see it come together will be really interesting. Because it's...
Sure, she has one leg, right?
That's she's... Yeah, you're right. They look a little bit...
Oh, maybe something... something bad happened.
She's balancing. No, she's got thin... feminine legs. Ah. It's perspective.
Oh, she's walking. That's why.
Do you know what?
She's coming to me.
I quit. I don't know what she's doing. She's just got small legs. That's all.
Oh, maybe she had an accident. I don't know. I mean, it's the apocalypse thing.
Yeah, it happens, you know. Yeah,
it
exactly.
All the time. I mean,
yeah, we don't know.
Something happened. That's it.
She's having a tough time.
Sammy Sweet Smile is asking, do you have a favorite thing to draw?
Landscapes. Yeah, landscapes. I think pretty much most things I do now will be landscapes, to an extent. They will normally also feature some sort of figure.
Mm-hmm.
I like to try and tell a story, so I think landscapes are the best way to do that. I'm not, you know, portraits, things like that, not really my thing. So, yeah, landscapes, lots of landscapes. Yeah, oops.
Yeah, portrait is more for Robzilla.
He's good at them.
Just leave them the portraits.
Yeah.
Have you ever met him? Oh, yeah, maybe in New York. At the workshop, yeah.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Yeah, he's great.
True.
Yeah, I believe he'll be doing... I think he'll be doing workshops at Max.
Oh, yeah, he would be there. Oh, yeah,
I know he's there. Yeah. Myself and a few others are going to be doing workshops on the apps as well at Max, so that'd be fun. See, this is the problem. I'm just going to keep adding details now. Maybe that's not a bad thing.
So Matt, who just joined, so Dan is using an iPad Pro and he's using Illustrator Draw, a free Adobe application on iOS and Android. So you can start downloading the app today and start drawing today. You can use your finger. You don't have to have an iPad Pro. It works on any iOS device and Android device. Who does the portrait? Oh, sorry, Ann Cooper. I was talking about Robzilla. Let me put the name in the chat. And his real name, Rob Generate the Third.
That's the one. Yeah.
The second one is not that good with portraits, but the third is definitely. Okay, I think we have 1 minute left. So I think it's time to say goodbye to our friends.
Okay.
And stay with us on Adobe Live because we will welcome Mara Grönlund just in 5 minutes. Make sure to stay with us, okay? On adobelive.com. If you are on YouTube, jump to adobelive.com. And we just, you know, let us 5 minutes, you know, to switch the stuff. And okay? Okay, you got it. Okay, so see you.
See you
soon.
Bye.